I decided to become a social entrepreneur for a couple of main reasons. Personally, I had a connection to, in particular, sub-Saharan Africa. So I'm of Afro-Caribbean heritage. And so there's always been this personal connection that I've had to the continent as kind of lost in the mist of time that connection may be. I've always had a desire to work, on the continent. And then at the same time, I'm also really passionate about energy. And energy is a massive enabler in terms of what it is that you can do with it. It's a really big multiplier in education. So when you have access to electricity, you improve your educational outcomes. Students are able to study after dark. It also facilitates, particularly in the modern world, communication, which allows people to access a whole range of different services. So I've got a mechanical engineering by background, and I have been kind of working in the kind of development sector. And then in my master's thesis, I was looking at thermoelectric generators being used in Kenya to generate electricity for decentralized applications. And one of the things that I came across in the literature and also experienced myself was the problem of trying to design a solution for other people who were living in a very, very different context. So for my master's project, we were six students working on this project, and at the end of the project, there were some issues that we couldn't have really foreseen, in particular, looking at the way in which people were likely to use the product within their homes. We weren't really able to take those things into account. We were very focused narrowly on the technical. And what we kind of found actually was that this was a problem that was going on across kind of the development sector, where people were designing solutions and then finding that, you know, in particular, when it came to maintenance, there were issues. So, for example, you know, there are pumps that are widespread across sub-Saharan Africa that break, and then no one knows how to fix them, and they just sit around essentially completely useless. And so this was the kind of core problem that I kept on seeing. And so what I tried to do was develop a product that allowed people who faced those problems to, in particular, we were focusing on renewable energy access, giving them the tools that they could go out and actually solve that problem for themselves, so that they weren't having to rely on external agencies, but I think more importantly, able to design better solutions because they had a better understanding of the context that they themselves were living in.